Hey everybody, Khan here again, and in this week's upload I'm going to take you through blocking and removing IE Snare, a particularly nasty piece of software that the bookmakers use to track your activity online. They say it's to combat fraud, but the reality is, if you've watched any other videos on this channel, you'll know they go to extreme lengths to block and restrict winning accounts. So in the next 5 steps, I'll take you through, start to finish, without any fluff, on how to remove and block this program. Let's not waste a second and get straight into it.
So step 1 is locating IE Snare files on your machine. It's really quite simple, so just follow along on screen. If you get lost at any point, give the video a pause while you catch up. So to start, we're going to go down to your start menu there, select search, and type in Notepad. In doing this, you'll see Notepad pops up on the start menu, but we don't want to select it with a left click. You want to give it a right click and select Run as Administrator. Very important that you do that, because if you don't, you won't be able to make the necessary changes later on. Once a verification prompt pops up, you want to select yes, which will give us the rights to change the properties that we need. Next, within Notepad, we're going to select File, Open, and then we're going to go to the following file path. I'm going to paste it in the top here. We'll leave it in the description below to make it nice and easy. Once you've pasted that in there, tap Enter, and it will take you to the correct folder. Now, down the bottom here, there's a little box and it says text documents only. We need to select that and make sure that all files are selected. This brings up your host file that includes all the necessary information that you're going to need to edit. Step 2, edit in the IE Snare host file. So now we're in the right location, we're going to right click our host file and select properties from the menu. We're doing this because we need to deselect the read only function for this file. This means that we're going to be allowed to edit it. Once doing that, we tap apply and confirm that it's okay to make these changes. Now we open up the host file, which will give you something like this. Step 3, adding commands to block IE Snare. So it's really quite simple, you just need to add some commands to the file on screen. So if we make that a little bit larger, and I will put a link in the description below, which will take you directly to a text file that will show you all the commands you need to add to this host file, shown on screen now. So I'll give all of those a select, copy, and create a new line inside our host file, and paste the following codes. So what this has done is this has added a whole load of commands to our host file, which says, you know, when IE Snare tries to do something, we're not going to allow it. Step 4, confirming activation. So once we've pasted the information inside a host file there, we're just going to File, Save as you would normally, and close it down before rebooting your machine. In doing this, it's going to activate all of those commands that we've just put inside our host file. So I'll be back in a second. Step 5, checking IE Snare is blocked properly. So once your machine's rebooted, you can check that the block is in place by going down to the start menu, typing into the search box CMD, which will bring up the command prompt. Then we're going to type in the following command, which is ping mpsnare.iesnare.com and tap enter. And the reply should come back as the following is on screen now in front of you. If it doesn't, then there's been a problem and you've made a mistake there. So go back to the start of this video and replay the entire process until it does come back with this reply.
So as you can see, it's really quite simple. If you've got anything to add to that tutorial there, please add it in the comments below. And while you're at it, tap that like button down the bottom corner. It really helps me out with growing the channel. Also, there's 2 videos here you can follow on screen that will show you exactly what happens if you don't block IE Snare.